Benz in my hand. Them Benzies in my hand. Cause I'm about my business, man. Yeah, I'm about my business, man. Put them Benzies in my hand. Them Benzies in my hand. Cause I'm about my business, man. You know I'm about my business, man. Trick with my money, yeah. I need cash. Trick with my money, yeah. I need cash. Trick with my money, yeah. I need cash. Put the Benzies in my hand. Cause I'm about my business, man. Stupid.
Now go get the money. Go get the money. Even if you gotta wear the strip pole.
I don't know what the fuck wrong with y'all, but we come here tonight to have a good time. It is motherfucking fault. COVID. It is motherfucking fault. Brothers, choking niggas and shit. We didn't go through all this shit. So tonight we gonna have a fun. And we gonna set this motherfucker all right.
You caress my skin. I'm under your command. Yeah. In the time with your eyes.
Yeah. If you don't know me by now, my name is Ronald Clinton and I'm from Marion County, Florida. So, DJ, cut the motherfucking music. Put your hands together for me. Put your hands together for me. You don't want to give me. You don't want to clap for me. And you gave somebody the claps in college. We won't talk about that. Yes, man, look at here, beautiful couples, beautiful people. How many in here with your side bitch? Who would ever tell? The side bitches know who they are. They stick to that nigga like gum on shoe. They just be, you know, I'll deal with this, I love you. But anyway, check this out this evening. We have 5 comedians here today to be able to entertain you. But they sent my black ass up here first to kind of polish y'all niggas up. I told him, I said, I ain't really got many jokes. Let me just tell him about how I run from police and snuff cocaine with thick-legged women. That's all I'm going to tell him about. I love to do it. I love cocaine, I love sex, and I love fast cars. 3 things about that shit. If your ass crash, shot, you're done. I'm an older nigga now. I love to fuck. And my brain, I'm 21, full of cum. But my body kind of rejects that shit, but you ain't got to worry about me fucking with these youngins. Or these youngins crazy. These youngins have dangerous sex, dangerous piercings, dangerous tattoos, and dangerous diseases. That COVID-19 is a motherfucker. Yeah, man, how many of y'all vaccinated in this bitch? Tell the truth. Tell the truth. Vaccinated. Thank God for you niggas. Fuck all y'all other herd immunity motherfuckers. I was just in the clinic getting my booster shot. Now, I went to the clinic to get my booster shot, but I never thought I would be at the clinic for that reason. I'm in there getting my motherfucking booster shot, and the damnedest thing about going to the clinic, you always see motherfuckers that you really don't supposed to see. Well, I saw my cousin Cleveland. He was walking down the motherfucking hall. He said, Cleveland! I said, what's up? He said, what are you doing? I said, get my booster shot. He said, man, I might as well get one. I just left him up the hall getting one in my ass. Dirty dick, nigga. Dirty dick. Which one of y'all family members dirty than a motherfucker when they come over to the house, your mama be like, don't let him use the bathroom. Don't let him use the bathroom. Jesus, hell no. Hell no. No. One of them kind of family members, when can I use the bathroom? They ask you, what do you have to do? The fuck you mean? I gotta use the bathroom. Well, I mean, you gotta be more specific. You know? Well, shit, well, I done polished y'all motherfuckers up enough. I want you to give a clap for yourself for coming out this evening. Let's go. Give a clap, hey. Well, I know y'all motherfuckers. Hey, give a clap for these niggas coming in here. Beautifully in red. I'm trying to tell you, boy, hey. Don't throw no tomatoes, because I'll pick your cherries. Girl, you look like you've got a whole bunch of foolishness. Well, I want to bring out the first comedian for the night. Hold on.
Bring it.
Nigga, shut up. You ain't the host. And you ain't finna try to come in here and help with me, goddammit. Fuck y'all. I'm get my goddamn this powder too, nigga. I'll tell you about your life. have me stink real fast. First comedian that has come to us this evening to entertain you, young nigga. I told you them young niggas dangerous, dangerous sex, dangerous diseases, COVID-19, I don't know. He looked like a walking booster shot, but his name is Cameron. Cameron, where are you at, Cameron?
Damn, boy, that shit, boy, you look bad in the bad bitch right now. That shit kind of, what the hell going on? And you from Stark? He from here? Y'all know this nigga? This y'all nigga? This y'all? You said no? He's not even claiming your ass, nigga. Where the fuck is you from?
Nah, he's a nigga from Jacksonville. I don't know where that nigga from. That nigga ain't from Stark, goddamn.
Where you from? Hey, listen here, don't ask me no goddamn questions. Alright? First of all, y'all look good. Give it up for y'all say I look good, man. Give it up for y'all say y'all look good. Well, just my hand in front, you look real good, boss man. Yeah, yeah. Now listen, I know y'all came in here real dapper, real nice and shit like that. I came in, bitch, in a white tee. I got told about it as soon as I walked through the door. So I'm like, you look fucking stupid. I'm like, god damn, bitch. You look dumb as hell with that white tee on, nigga. I said, damn. I just got out working. I was, you know what I'm saying? Y'all know what I do. What I do? Tell me. Not a damn thing. You got that right. I don't got no motherfucking job, bitch. I do fucking comedy and I'm broke, bitch. I'm broke as shit. Y'all better laugh so I can get booked again and fucking start. I like y'all town. This shit nice. I got a nice ass little town, man. This shit cool, man. I ain't really seen too much. I ain't got no fucking street lights nowhere. Y'all don't got no fucking street lights. Where the fuck the street lights at? Y'all must be doing some fucked up shit up here at Stark, man. I like the little town. I mean, I was in Iowa with y'all Crockers a couple weeks ago in Bradford. Iowa with y'all Crockers, yeah. And listen, I did a show in Bradford, and the white dude came up to me like, hey, man, hey, boy, you pretty fucking funny. I was like, oh, shit. And listen, I was outnumbered, so I know what to say. Like, boy, you pretty funny, boy. Let me buy you a drink. What is that? That's somebody, yeah, didn't he? He said, let me buy you a drink. I'm going to buy you a drink, boy. He said, we're drinking on Hennessy. I said, bitch, you're right. How you guess that? How you know I was drinking on some Hennessy? So, the man bought me a drink. We talking and shit like that. He like, hey, man, you finna drive home? I said, nah, man, I'm not finna drive home. He said, well, you finna drive home? Just know the police out here racist. I said, he said, yeah, man, you got tinted windows? I said, nah, my windows ain't tinted. He said, good, good, good. I mean, you know what, man, fuck that joke. But I was really in y'all sitting, I ain't gonna lie to you. Y'all really hurt. I really hurt. Now I'm lying. I really got a job. Y'all really invest. I take y'all that far. Y'all really messed with me. I apologize. I'm so sorry.
I'm scared. Listen,
all right? But I ain't no bitch neither. You feel what I'm saying? So I don't feel nobody. Only feel God. Then I met her brother. I go, okay, I feel God or your brother. That's a big ass nigga. All right? And to come find out her brother got out of prison the day before I met him. So I go to meet her brother. He go, listen here, bro. I'm going to tell you some real shit. You put your hands on my little sister. Hear my little sister any type of way. Or you break her heart. I will not kill you. I'm going to torture your ass until you beg for me to die. He was looking at me like this the whole time. Nigga wouldn't even blink. I'm like, this nigga's crazy. But like, I don't really listen to shit, so that day, she was sucking my dick, right? Yeah. When she was sucking my dick, I put a finger in my booty. Now listen.
In your booty?
In my booty.
Damn.
I don't play that shit, bro. So I thumped her head real fast. I'm like, bitch, what the fuck put a finger in my booty, bitch? I thumped on top of the head real fast. And she was like, I thought a little too hard. I thought a little too hard, bro. But she started crying a little bit. And she was like, I'm finna tell my brother. I said, hold up, bitch. Just go slow. Now you finna put a finger in my booty, bitch. You put a wetter or something first, bitch. You better call that goddamn maniac over there. Boy, his ass gonna kill me. Fuck. Damn, my love. Y'all, give it up for y'all. Say y'all a good ass crowd, man. I fuck with y'all, and I'm drunk. I'm drunk as shit, boy. I'm gonna follow these goddamn preacher steps. I might not make it back to the. Oh, yeah, if y'all ain't know, but I'm from Orlando. So if I'm not having a good set, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to tell everybody on that. I did amazing. So it don't matter. I'm going to go back. Like, I was a star, nigga. All these hoochies wanted to fuck me. It was crazy. It was amazing. Now, any lesbians in here? Ain't no lesbians in here? Nigga with a lace front. Nigga, you a lesbian your damn self. Nigga, nah, listen. I envy lesbians. Because they can take their dick off, and I can't do that, because my dick not that big, what I'm trying to say, you know what I'm saying? It's not, you feel me? And I ain't been asking because they can go to the store and pick out whatever dick they want. They ain't go that big. Listen, I want a fucking 12, give me the 12 up there, you know what I'm saying? If I'm fucking the bitch, she gonna get these shits out the quick way, she gonna enjoy herself. Real shit, you know what I'm saying? A lesbian fuck her girlfriend, and she can fuck her girlfriend, she be like, hold on, go deeper. All she gotta do is take that 6 off, go to the truck real quick, and pull out a 10. If I'm fucking my girlfriend, tell me to go deeper. I'ma just call my homeboy. Cause obviously this bitch ain't see the thing I came in with, that bitch disrespectful. Disrespectful at me. Y'all like that too? It's alright. It's okay. Like I, what I told y'all earlier, I'm gonna tell everybody myself, I did amazing. Every my door was hit, goddamn. I did great. Back to the biting people though, man. When I was a little kid though, man, I had no trouble with biting people. I had to bite people because I got little sisters. My little sister is 6'3", 280. That's a big bitch. Right, that's an extremely big bitch. Y'all don't know how bad it is to get beat up by a little girl and she 10 years old and you 15, alright? Cause she been 6'3", she was fucking 5. That shit don't make no goddamn sense. You hear me? Y'all been laughing before I call last. Oh, goddamn. She done run through the whole fucking row. The whole back row and shit. Really, shit, my shit's big as hell. My biggest fiddle, though, as she come in with that go camera, have whatever, he beat my ass. I'm looking dead eyes, go, what the fuck you gonna do? But I can't fight for you, bitch. You the heavyweight champ of the world, but I can't fight for you. Damn. That bill going so good at the beginning, wasn't it? This shit was going so good. It's like, nigga, this nigga not funny no more. I don't like this nigga no more. This nigga need to get a different shirt or something. Nigga need to change his clothes. Nigga, you not dressed up enough to be a fucking star right now. Man, get up here and say it one more time, man. Yes, sir.
They say they want some step of shit.
Young nigga, come back so I can tell you about how I'm gonna get your auntie pregnant tonight. Let's change the scene in this shit. I ain't finna talk about no fingers in the booty. But I'ma talk about big dick nigga shit. Ladies, put your hands together if you like a big shiny dick. Oh, you don't? You don't? Well, I was gonna tell you about how I go dick shopping with the lesbians. I'd be right in there with them. You'd be right over there at that truck stop, right up the way, just, hey, you wanna get a 10-incher? Look at mine. You should match it up to this. But anyway, it goes, Cortez is a funny young man, and I'm glad that you all came out here this evening to chill with us. Well, ladies, it's Christmas time. This is the best time of the year to fucking trick. The best fucking time to trick. Niggas who love to trick be tricking around Christmas. You just do not know. I got so many pussies to get off a layaway. I will get your pussy right off a layaway. And have conversations with you. Well, you know, I got a couple of, right now is now. I will take it off and lay away. It's the best time of the year to trip. My auntie ain't shit. She get a boyfriend for 2 months going into the shit. After Thanksgiving, she got a nigga. After January the 1st, there goes the nigga. And let me tell you something, I love my black women. But y'all motherfuckers ain't shit around tax season. All the other time of the year, you get the nigga that you can. And in that run of the short periods of months, you get the nigga that you want. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. I love tricking around income tax. You know what I'm saying? I tell them that D-boy shit, hey, baby, go ahead and let me get a couple so I can flip that thing. And when I flip it, I'm going to go ahead and give it back to you double. And then you fucking have a baby and you be fucked up double. Getting audited by the IRS and on child support. Give a round of applause for that shit. Give a round of applause to the niggas who hate their baby mamas. I'm pretty sure that she hates your motherfucking ass too. That's why she's going back to court. We're going to adjust this shit. We're going to get this shit together. You know what I'm saying? No good and damn well that niggas don't like their cheering. Talking about some, I'm going to fight for half custody. Trying to get out of child support. But look, I'm glad you all came out here this evening to have fun with us again. I keep telling you motherfuckers that because I love you and you're beautiful and you're out here and these women is dressed beautifully. But we got this next comic getting ready to roll up here. He was up here fucking with me earlier with his semi-vertical edge. You know what I'm saying? But he's a cool nigga and I heard he's very, very funny and he's supposed to go ahead and entertain you tonight. The nigga ain't funny. His name is David Jolly. David Jolly, could you please come to the stage? Please come to the stage, David Jolly. DJ, play this motherfucker some music or something.
Go shawty, it's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip, it's your birthday.
to start. What's up? Put your hands together, man. God damn, who gave this nigga some money? I hope y'all ain't paying this nigga. This nigga got that bad-ass perm in. That nigga got goddamn parquet in the back of his head. You remember parquet, the bad butter? You know the fuck I'm talking about. How y'all doing tonight? Put your hands together. Bitch, y'all like y'all at a goddamn funeral, bitch. My name is David Jolly. I'm not finna stand up there because I got bad knees. And if y'all don't laugh at me, I'm gonna pull my dick out. So that's what's gonna happen. Play this shit how y'all want to. I don't give a damn. Y'all don't know me that much. My name's David Jolly. I'm a guy who turned 37 years old, and I decided I wanted to be a professional comedian. My aunt, she got a better name for it. She likes to call me a disappointment. And I'm glad that bitch is dead. Yeah, it's real in this bitch. So I just got my weed license. Y'all got y'all weed license? Y'all got dispensaries down here? Where you can buy weed like good old common white folks? Just got my goddamn weed license. Only thing is that I'm a professional weed smoker. I be thinking about all kind of crazy shit. Hey, you calm down. Like, I be thinking about all kind of crazy shit. I was thinking to myself the other day, I ain't gay or nothing. But, for the right amount of money, I fuck Wendy Williams. Because you know that bitch got a dick on her. That bitch dick bigger than mine. No, that bitch got an old soldier on her. Fucking Wendy Williams. Yeah, you goddamn mind. I was high. I was very high. Very high. No, that's goddamn dude. And I'm tired of social media, though, man. Y'all got you got social media? What you on, bro? What you on?
I'm on Snapchat on your ass.
Hell yeah. Snapping and chatting and shit. Hell yeah. Got them little ass pants on, too.
Hell yeah. And I'm pressing in the motherfucker, too.
All right, we ain't gonna do this now. Come on.
You did that.
You just relax.
You did that.
Ain't got on that Buccaneer 85 outfit. You gave that nigga $30. Nigga, go out there and show out with them $30, nigga. Nigga, you got $30, nigga. Show your ass with them 30. All right, I don't want no problems, because that nigga going to come up here with $12,000. He been waiting all year to show them $12,000. All right, you right. I'm sorry. You look good. Hey, give it up for my brother right there. What's your name, brother? All right, that's his name. You give it down. Y'all good? Y'all good out here, though? What's his name? Stark? I forgot we was in Stark. Last time we was out here, we was at Jimmy's spot. We was in, what they call that, the Fat Grounds? Y'all remember that party? Y'all ain't come. Stinkin'. Well, none of y'all there. It was just me and them other niggas that were waiting on them goddamn $247. Shit! And the niggas are talkless in the store. Shit. Nah, it's good times out here in the store, man. The collard greens good. Who cooking collard greens tonight for tomorrow? Bitch, clap y'all hands if y'all cooking collard greens. I know some of you hoes out here cooking collard greens. Oh yeah, like y'all, all right, y'all right, they ain't hoes. He like, hoes? My grandmama ain't no hoe. That bitch just like to cook collard greens. So I was hanging out with my rich friends the other day in what's the name of that other city over there, Jacksonville. You know they were doing all kind of rich people stuff, like smoking crack, doing meth. The shit I can't afford. So the whole time I'm over there in Duval, you know what I'm saying? I'm sitting in the same goddamn spot, because if anything come up missing in here, you would not blame my black ass for it. That ain't how it's going to happen. So my buddy Bartholomew, his mom comes upstairs, and she's like, hey, Bartholomew, because that's how rich people talk. Hey, Bartholomew, do you want some of my cucumber sandwiches? And tell Jolly I'm frying some chicken. Exactly, that shit racist. So Bart, his mom comes upstairs. So Bart, he get pissed. He's like, God damn it, mom. Nobody wants any of your goddamn cucumber sandwiches. We're trying to do cocaine. And Jolly doesn't eat chicken. He's a vegan. Y'all ain't laughing because you know that's a goddamn lie. Bitch, I love chicken. I got chicken in my pocket. I did that same joke in Jacksonville, Florida. As soon as I said, he's a vegan, a white lady stood up and said, nigga, please. All right, y'all paying attention. Y'all just holding them back. Y'all thought I was going to sit up here with this mass choir shit. This is goddamn Macedonia. Ain't this a Baptist church? Why Baptist churches have all these pews in? We in the church? This is church? All right, cool. I don't want no problems. I don't know who church this is. This is my granddaddy church. Fought nigga, he used to kill people, and I'm going to kill you. Damn, I'm going to dive here in the church on the pew on the seventh step. Nigga ain't trying to die on step four. Nigga, die. I want to die in the pulpit so I can go home like Jesus. All right, I'm just high as hell. I'm talking crazy. That nigga look good, don't he? You look good. What's your name, brother? Dickie Chicken? City Chicken? I'm gonna mess up. I'm sorry. What'd you say? Slick Chicken. Y'all give it up for Slick Chicken and this bitch. Bitch, y'all clap y'all fucking hands. Act like y'all. Bitch, we in Bradford County. Act like y'all brand new enough because y'all got a table with a bottle of effing. Y'all got one bottle of effing in this bitch here. Now y'all brand new. Y'all give it up for Dickie Chicken. Chicken Dickie out here. Dickie Chicks with the dick. Hell yeah, Dickie Chicken, Chicken Dickie. That nigga look like he fuck midgets. I've been wanting to fuck a midget my whole life. If I ever get my hands on a midget, I'ma hold that bitch down and put so much dick in that hole. I'm talking a real midget, the ones that breathe like this. Like half breaths. I don't want no full breath midget, bitch. That's why I fuck my fat girls on their back. And I put them legs up for 45 minutes of pressure. If you live after this, we go together. You ever fuck the fat girl for 45 minutes like this? And she be like this. You can see her about to pass out a little bit. Let my fupa go. Hey, y'all giving up Tez Brooks in the building, man. Y'all giving up Tez Brooks. Put your hands together, bitch. I'm just saying Tez Brooks in the building. The fuck is that? Y'all like y'all slow or something. All right, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to talk to y'all like that. Because I can't fight that well. That's why I get up there on them stairs. That's them Baptist stairs. Remember your grandma who used to be a Baptist? Your daddy mama was a Baptist because she tried to pray for all his sins. That nigga still ain't shit. Is this a church? Because I don't want to go all the way to hell. I know I'm going. I just want to have like a little leeway in between where I can be like, surprise, bitch, and come back out and just go on to hell. I know where I'm going. You got to know where you're going. Hey, y'all give it up for my young nigga Cameron Patterson. He came up here and did his thing. Hey, listen. That nigga been doing this thing 6 months professionally. You hear me? You know how much nuts it take to get up here? Give it up for Cameron Patterson again. That's my young nigga. Should I get up here? Can y'all see me better? Hey, this polo got like 3 stains on that bitch. I don't know if it's around the arm. Y'all don't give a damn. Y'all ever wore a polo with a stain on it on stage? You ever fucked a midget with an allergy? Yeah, bitch, you ain't had a good time till you fucked a midget. That bitch just sound like this. You hit her from the back of the front, they go. Hey, I ain't fucking no. You talking about, yeah, you got one time up here. That nigga like he got $100,000 to see a nigga fuck a midget. I'll fuck a midget for $38. Trying to get out of here. I'm in that real shitty ass hotel down the road. They just psyched me out. They told me this was a Marriott. This ain't got shit to do with Marriott. What is called the All In? All In? The All In? People living there for real. I knew it was bad when I see a nigga living in there. He said, nigga, what you want to drive through? Wash? I said, no, nigga, I want to find my room. So, nigga, you been here before. This ain't your first time. You been here a long time. He said, yeah, nigga, they got 2 for $15 in the back. In the front, they trying to let them go only for 10. Talking about it's a whole 1 gram. Nigga, what? I just want to get to the comedy show, bro. See it, man. Y'all know what I'm talking about. What road is Temple Terrace? What is it, Temple Avenue? All right, don't worry about it. Who in this bitch trying to make $40? All right, y'all brand new. Okay, cool. Don't worry about it. I know where to go. I'm going to go right on Backpage.com. No, Backpage dead. You got to go on this problem. And you got to go to Jacksonville. Jacksonville bitches, them bitches be having like... The back of their underarms kind of stink a little bit. It's just the back. Like, you can't, like, let them lift their whole arm right in your face because you'll pass out. Like, mini-wise. What the fuck am I talking about? Y'all having a good time? So I ain't got to pull that dick out. The dick on 7. And she's like, nah, at all. I'll put it out around you now, girl. What's your name is? Susan? You got a Susan wig on. I ain't fucking with no more bitches unless y'all wear wigs. And I'm talking about them auntie wigs, too. The ones that switch to the side. You don't know if it's the front or the back. You know what type of wig I'm talking about, where she wear it to the front and she turn it around. You don't even know that's the whole back way. That's a whole nother person. You out here just showing that, auntie. About to make me show you both of them inches. Damn, I'm glad y'all laughing. Let's have a moment of silence. Why y'all left? Y'all gonna have a moment of silence with me or not? All right, everybody bow their heads. No, serious, I'm being serious. I'm being serious. Everybody, can y'all bow y'all heads? Y'all got y'all heads bowed? I think y'all lying. My head was bowed while y'all, I think y'all lying to me. Please, it's a serious situation, serious. Well, yeah, y'all don't believe me?
No.
Why? Because my eyebrows. I knew I should have got my shit arched. All right, y'all know y'all head is serious. I can't believe y'all feel me that shit. All right, it's my time. Nigga, don't give me no light. Nigga, you got that little ass shirt on. Look at that nigga with that little shirt going towards the door. Nigga got little ass shirt on. No, his family don't care about him. So I had one joke. It was one joke. Damn, that shit was good. Hey, y'all got Facebook, right? Everybody got Facebook in here? You know how, like, on Facebook, it be the people they send you them friend requests, them motherfucking scammers, them goddamn Forex motherfuckers and shit? These motherfuckers then sent me a friend request and made a fake Facebook profile of me and sent it to me. I accept it. Like I said, I'd be high as hell. I'd be real high. So me and me talking, right? Me and me talking, I'm talking to me, and me like, hey, how Gloria doing? I'm like, what? How this nigga know my mama name? This might be me. So me and me going back and forth, I knew me wasn't me when me asked me for $50. Because I know I ain't got $50 just be giving away willy-nilly like that, you know? Like I said, I'm a single guy, you know? I do all my shopping. I stay by myself. So when you come over, you can leave them stank-ass sandals right there. I like girls with stank sandals. All right, don't worry about that. So, like, me, I'm single, so I do all of my shopping. Well, every other single guy who live by himself doing shopping, guess where that's at, boss man? You know where. My mother's house. You goddamn right I go shopping at my mama's house. So I'm at my mama's house, and all I hear is, push it real good. I'm like, ain't nothing good gonna come out of this. Because my mama told me this is a song I was created off of. First of all right, that ain't gonna work. I'm going to end like this here. Hey, thank y'all for coming out. I'm not going to do that joke. Thank y'all for coming out. Give it up for yourself. Bitch, y'all clap y'all fucking hands. Hey, where the nigga at with the bad perm? That nigga Ben gave me the light. Where the nigga at? All right. That nigga with the bad perm.
Bitch. Jumping jacks about the outfit. Making that trap house jump quick.
DJ, you colder than the motherfucker. That nigga cool. Keep my music down. You don't follow directions, but you play good music. Fuck with a real nigga.
Well, how do you think it's going? How's it going, Stark, Florida? We having a good time tonight? Yes, sir. I love it. Hey. I want to give a big shout out to a cool ass dude I recently had the chance of meeting who put this shit together. You know what I'm saying? Who gave us this venue, this way to be able to come in and do this shit. Man, y'all go ahead and clap it up for Mr. Motivation. Hopefully he'll invite a motherfucker back. Who knows? Motivation. And give a shout out to his better half. He told me to make sure that I put her in this because we know who run the shit on the back end. Queen B. Look at here, man, if the back end ain't working, fuck the front. Ain't no front if the back ain't working. If your asshole shut down, see what the fuck the front do. If your asshole shut down, see what it's gonna do. That's on the ass end, shit go blank. You got the shit, time stops.
Where's your social security, nigga?
Nah, but look. I was just up there looking at my man, and he was a good comment, but he kind of offended me. I didn't like how he was talking about the fat girls. Bless their heart. I love them. And they always smell so good. Breath smells like baby snacks and body lotions, and look, I would never in my life put your legs back for 45 minutes and go crazy. I wouldn't do that. Dick too long, you can put your leg down. You can put it down. Give a round of applause if you like fucking with the lights on. I was gonna say, ain't no freaks in here who like fucking with the lights on. I like fucking with the lights on, seeing how much my body changed. You know, but we me and Mo later, we ended up putting the mirror in an awkward place of the bathroom. You know, it's like one of them stand-up mirrors where you can stand up in front of it and see how good you look. Just like one of them. And I was in that bitch, and I was curbside and hitting that thing from the side like this. And that thing from the side like this, and I caught a bad angle. I said, oh shit, is that my asshole? No. It was just my belly button. But I love the fuck, you know, and I love aggressive women. I love aggressive women. Big, tough, just
give me that nigga dick. Give it to him.
Just one of them. And I ran across one of them the other day. And she told me, she said, you know, Clean, I've been looking at you for a while, and I figured in my mind that I'm going to give you some pussy. I said, heavens the Father, for real, man? You're so considerate. She says, yeah, but I must warn you. There's some dangerous pussy. I got paycheck pussy. And it's a prerequisite to it. She said, to get this, you need a safety word. She said, what's your safety word, nigga? I said, bitch, stop. She said, no, really, what is it? I said, bitch, stop. I said, cool, come on, let's go. So she grabbed it. And she looked at it. She looked at it, paid good attention to it. She said, nigga, you ready for this? I said, yes, ma'am. She said, what's your safety word? I said, bitch, stop. She said, it's a paycheck pussy. I said, oh, yeah, heavens to God. What is that? She said, finish short tail. Man, big mama got that thing right. She said, you ready for the paycheck pussy? I said, yeah. I said, she said, you ready? I said, yeah. And I knew exactly what she meant when she sat on it. She said, light bill. I said, oh,
She said, cable bill. I said, oh. She said, credit cards, kids, crew, school, band. Oh, bitch, get off of me. I got to go to work. Stop. The paycheck pussy. Yes, it's dangerous. Stay away from it. Pussy so good, I called the police on her, I called it. But anyway, let's stop talking about my old sex life and me catching angles and everything. And we're going to talk about this comedian that's coming up. Now, when I was on my porch the other day, and I called this young man, I was snorting so much powder, feeling good, and he made me feel better talking to him. I said, goddamn, nigga, you just a real positive nigga. I want to go do more cocaine. He says, go ahead, clean. Snort your life away. And I said, good. So, it's a plus and a negative. So after tonight, I'm going to NA, and I'm going to take that nigga with that ashy shirt to AA. Put your hands together for tell it, like it, yeah!
I love y'all, man.
What's happening, y'all? Hold up. Y'all have been treating me like old hot dog water around this bitch. I done some things in my career. I say, what's happening, damn it? Real shit. How many of y'all done seen me before? Make some noise. Good. Y'all just don't realize. Have you ever seen Comic View? You ever seen Comic Central? Did you see BET Def Comedy Jam? Good, because I ain't been on none of that shit. But I am here tonight, goddamn. My career is taking off. All right. Shout out to the DJ, y'all. Bro back here doing his thing and shit. I just want to know how much they had to pay Biz Markie to come from the grave and do one more set. Damn, boy. But DJ back here doing his thing, though. He been chopping it up the whole damn time, real talk. Being a DJ is a hard job because a lot of rappers, they ain't rapping about shit no more. They teach these young kids that they supposed to eat booty like groceries. I don't know about them, but bitch, I cook all my groceries. I'm just saying, I don't see nothing wrong with eating a little ass once it reached 350. Hell, I eat a big ass when it reached 350. If you ain't laughing, you don't eat ham. Real talk. Boy, it feels good to be back on this stage. Boy, COVID got the world fucked up, don't it? Give yourselves a round of applause being out here, y'all. Give yourselves a round of applause. Oh, man. COVID got us wearing these masks and shit. COVID taught some people what the rest of us already knew, though. It taught some people that their breath really stinks. You know your breath bad if it make your own eyes water. Breath smell like corn sauce. Just crying for no. I had one dude come up to me just apologizing for no reason. He had his mask on. He had burped. He was like, bro, I'm sorry. And what's crazy is, if you look at these people, I'm going to tell you, you know how to tell when these people really have stinky breath or not. I want you to think about it. Over 800,000 people done died from COVID. And you got your mask under your nose like, bitch, I'll take my chances. Your breath so bad, you'll rather risk dying than smell your own breath. You know it's got to be that. Man, some people around here don't want to get vaccinated. But I found out that some people don't want to get vaccinated for totally different reasons than you think. A lot of people know that once they get fully vaccinated and that mask come off, they right back to being ugly again. I'm just saying, they just can't go back to the old days. Y'all really don't know how many ugly babies done been born this year. They got pretty eyes and nothing else. They do exist. It's all right. A lot of things done changed since the last time we was able to get get on this stage and I'm going to talk about it all. At this point in time, I would like to take the time to say, Black Lives Matter. Do y'all agree? Shit. I can't tell. Let me hear. Black Lives Matter. Shit, especially mine. Just in case anybody asks you. Damn. But I figured out that if you notice that once was a time when you thought of something racist, when you heard of anything racist, you instantly knew it was black people and white people. If you heard of something racist, it was black people and white people. But now I done figured out racism ain't so racist. Anybody could get it. I seen a commercial that said, stop Asian hate. Stand in solidarity with the Asians against racism. And I was thinking to myself, black people were the original recipients of racism. Nigga, we didn't get no commercial. Nigga, we didn't get no slogan. Nigga, we've been robbed for racism. They said stand with solidarity with the Asians against racism. Look, Asians was confused. They came and stood with us like, hey, what we do? For real, but if you notice, it made Asians and black people closer. There once was a time, I was born in the 70s, grew up in the 80s, and there once was a time when the only thing Asian people would say to black people was, hurry up and buy. Not no more. We friends now. They want to, my friend, want to teach you the language and shit? Konnichiwa. You say. But have you ever noticed, and this is some real shit, have you ever noticed you can go to any Chinese restaurant right now, you can order your food, and you can say, can I get a shrimp fried rice? And she'll repeat it back to you. She'll say, can I get shrimp fried rice? And you'll be like, yes. She will turn around and she'll talk to the cook. And she'll be like, and he will reply back. She would turn around and look right at you and say, he say okay. No the hell he did. If it took him that long to say okay in his language, he would have learned English a long time ago. I'm just saying, it's true. I don't give a shit. I'm going to talk about Asian people. The reason why I talk about Asian people is because Asian people wear flip-flops. And I'm not talking about slides. I'm talking about flip-flops with the little thing in between the toe. See, I don't give a damn how mad you get or no matter what situation you in, the way you going to do. You can't look hard in flip-flops. Because no matter what I do to you, the next move you make will not be manly. If I push you in your flip-flops between the toes, you got to do one or two things. You got to either tap your ass over there to fight, or you got to do the next best thing, which is do like a woman would do and slide them bitches off. You can't be manly in flip-flops. That's why men wear slides. It's real. Everything ain't for every damn body. And that's the truest statement I ever heard. Just like we got some plus-size women in here, but I'm going to be real with y'all. A lot of plus-size people don't need to lose weight because you really look better big. It's true. You can't be going out getting this gastric bypass surgery and shit and losing all this weight, and now your ass look like you melted. Loose skin just every damn well. How your whole body need to be circumcised? Shit don't make no sense. You got to be yourself. Your size 3 ain't gonna look like her size 3. Your size 3 look like a mosquito wrapped in a mink coat. Bitch, skin don't fit. Shit, how the hell you outside is chilly? You talking about, ooh, I'm gonna cover up with my own shoulder skin. Can't do that shit to yourself. Got to be you. That's just like everybody want to have a big ass nowadays. Got women going out getting ass injections, butt implants and shit. But what I failed to realize, how is it your ass is this big, but your legs this little? Body made like a termite. You wondering why this man won't show me where he live. He said you finna eat the baseboards out the house. Shit, you can't have just as much stomach as you got ass. Body shaped like a curvy road. Man trying to rub you down, he just... Ooh, she handles rough in the curves. Everybody got ass nowadays, don't they? Even white women got ass nowadays. I remember when I was growing up, white women used to be on TV with the little leotard and the string in their ass and shit. They don't know. Come on, Rebecca, work those buns. And one, and two, and three. What? Not no more. White women making twerk videos and shit. Singing songs. It's all about the bass, no treble. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, I seen a sister walking down the street. Last she been taking that new medication. No acetol. I'm serious. Her ass was sunk so far in, her little booty was in the front. She gonna try to tell me she had had a C-section. Girl, I know an asshole when I see one. Everything ain't for every damn body. That's just like you can't have long lashes in a lazy eye. Yeah, I said, and if you didn't hear it, damn it, I said it again. You can't have long lashes in a lazy eye. Looking like one of them 1985 baby dolls. Oh, y'all know the one I'm talking about, don't you? Uh-huh, y'all had one too. You lay this bitch down, her eye closed. You pick up, they supposed to open, but one gets stuck. Stop doing that to yourselves, old Forrest Whitaker face ass. Shit, we live right here in Florida, and I know everybody love to be out and about and feel free, but bitch, open-toe shoes ain't for every damn body. That's real. There's some women in this room right now ought to be wearing steel-toe stilettos. I'm gonna be real. When your feet look like goat hoofs, if you make that click-clack sound even when you barefoot, you know the one who sound like a Clydesdale horse on a brick road. Even when you on carpet, just... Your ass ain't got no business in no damn open-toe shoe. Nothing worse than me the person's body look brand new and they feet look used. Oh, they exist. I'm telling you, I was in a date one time down in Tampa. Took the little chick to the beach. It was all romantical. The waves was rushing in. Whoosh. She took off her shoes. Walked through the wave. The wave rushed out. Whoosh. And never came back, bitch. For real, you got to take care of your damn feet. Everything just ain't for every damn body. That's just like I feel like the dollar store shouldn't be allowed to sell pregnancy tests. That's real. Because the truth is, if your ass at the dollar store buying a pregnancy test, bitch, you can't afford a positive. Oh, this shit finna get real.
Talk your shit, nigga.
Better say it. That's the cheapest part of the damn pregnancy. Do you realize when it comes to children, you spend the first 2 years of a child's life teaching them to walk and talk? Too bad we turn around and spend the next 16 trying to teach them to sit down and shut the hell up. And then the state got the nerve to tell you that they don't want you to spank these kids. They'll tell you some shit like riddling curious bad behavior. I told them that's what the fuck I named in my belt. I named my belt Ritalin. See, for y'all that don't understand, I'm explaining this to you so y'all will know next time. When your child is in a public place, it ain't like it used to be no more. You can't just snatch that child up. Hey, I'm going to whoop your ass. Oh, no. You finna go to jail. Yes, sir. You going. You got people calling the police on their Bluetooth, and you ain't even know it. They'll speak to you and everything. They be like, yes, officer. We need someone down here to the local Walmart. Hi, sir. How you doing? Kids out of control, aren't they? Yes, officer, could you please hurry? I can see it in the child's eyes. He's going to need help. Listen, your ass is going to go to jail. But when you name your belt Ritalin, you snatch their little asses up like, hey, little boy, you need some of this damn Ritalin. They be like, oh, it's okay, officer. He's got his medication. Oh, it's fine. He's going to give it to him in the car. All right, thank you. Make people mind their business. See, when I was growing up, wasn't no such thing as ADD. Wasn't no such thing as ADHD. There was nothing a good ass whooping wouldn't cure. Oh, I'm serious. I got my ass whooped with everything. Extension cord, water hose. Hell, I don't even be used as the weapon. I'm serious. I was jumping on the bed. My uncle caught me by the ankles, cocked my ass back, and swung me like a Louisville slugger. Took my sister out just. I used to hate it when my mama whooped my ass, though. That was the worst ass whooping in the world. I hated that because my mama was religious. And before she'll whoop my ass, she'll take the time to show you in the Bible where you was wrong. And then she'll take the time to show you that scripture where if you spare the rod, you spoil the child. And then she hit me with the most player line I ever heard before in my damn life. She would tell me that bullshit that this gonna hurt me more than it hurt you. I remember thinking to myself, well, give me the belt, let me beat your ass then. That's some real shit. But as I got older, I figured out what the hell she was talking about. I really did, because I got daughters of my own now. They like to argue and fight and bicker and shit. And one day, I came home and they locked up like two big bulls in front of the Christmas tree. I said, that's it. I done had enough of this shit. Bring me the Ritalin. Finna get some straightening. Before I do, though, I'm going to take the time to show y'all what y'all wrong. And then I broke out the Bible and I showed them in the Bible where if you spell the rod, you spoil the child. And I myself got to use that infamous line. This shit gonna hurt me more than it hurt you. I grabbed one of them, I cocked my belt back and swung forward, bow, and pulled the muscle in my damn back. Lord, this pain shot through my head like I was struck by lightning. That shit was ridiculous. My baby standing over me and told me, Daddy, you okay? Oh, shit, this shit is your damn fault. Why my weed smokers in this business? Y'all just gonna have y'all own little personal conversations and shit. Any weed smokers there? Y'all act like this is a job convention. Y'all bosses in this bitch? Hello? Is this motherfucker on? Rental center, your shit ain't working or something. I know goddamn well y'all gonna be hearing something. Is there any weed smokers in this bitch? Ah, damn. I'm no. Boy, y'all a rough crowd. Shit, I never did one time a motherfucker told me. Here recently, dude gonna tell me talking about marijuana was a gateway drug. I told that bitch at 45 years old, if I ain't been through the gate by now, it's cause I ain't going. Sick. I love smoking weed. Nothing wrong with that. You ever got in your car, fired up your blunt, and forgot where the fuck you was going? I did. The only reason I'm saying that because y'all don't know, I almost didn't make this show. I was like, damn, I know it was somewhere I was supposed to goddamn be. I was just riding around, my gas light came on and shit. Anthony called me, so I tell it like it is, you gonna make it to this show? I was like, oh shit, I knew I was supposed to be somewhere. But there are signs that you smoke too much weed. Really. There really are signs you smoke too much weed. The number one sign that you smoking too much weed is, that shit was right on the tip of my tongue, too. And that's usually what happens, but see, Some of us done went through so too many damn gates is the problem. Some of us done tried too many drugs. You know, I can tell you one drug I couldn't try. I damn sure couldn't try heroin. Ain't no way in hell. If I was a heroin addict, you would have to feed it to me. I'm scared of needles. Ain't no way in hell. I'd be watching them cook that shit up one day. How I'm supposed to put that hot ass spoon in my mouth? Hey man, that's my time for tonight. Before I leave, I always leave on a serious note. Don't clap your shit, hold the fuck up. Goddamn y'all premature clapulation. Look, before I leave the stage, I would leave on a serious note. And my serious note tonight is, be sure to teach these kids to say no to drugs. Especially weed. This way the prices go down and I can get the good shit for cheap. I am telling like it is. Goddamn it. Ike Turner, come get this goddamn microphone. Somebody get Ike up here. Thank you.
That nigga got a big dick. Well, that's what he was doing. He had in like the white boy said, he was pouring the coals on her. He was like, yeah. 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 The nigga bust in the house. This lady ain't even see him. She was lost in pleasure. She was getting long dick. Well, he ran to the other room and he grabbed his 38 and he pulled it out. He said, hey, motherfucker. Back up. That nigga say, little mama say, ugh. He say, motherfucker, I said, back up. That nigga say, mama say, ugh. But that nigga was frustrated. He cocked the bitch back. He said, motherfucker, I said, back your ass up. That nigga backed up again. Man, that nigga seen all that meat and blew his own motherfucking brains out. Hey, so you gotta have the conversation, the shit that you can never come back from. You got to. You gotta have that conversation. So tonight, before you get ready to have some pussy, have a conversation. Enjoy each other. Clap it up for your motherfucking self. Clap it up for Black Love. And clap it up for you being at this show. And I so greatly appreciate you for coming. Now look, hold on. Wait a minute. Nigga, what this say right here? Right now. God damn, you can play music, but you can't read. Okay, yeah, Cortez Brooks, that's who that is. Can you play me some music, DJ? Lord bless your motherfucking heart. Put your hands together for Cortez Brooks!
Hold on, y'all. That nigga just did me so dirty. Nigga asked me for a song and still played the role, so.
Baby, uh-uh.
Hold on, wait, cut it, DJ. We about to do this one more time, alright? Y'all ready? Y'all got me fucked up. I'm about to show my ass and start floating. I swear to God. Coming to the stage, man! I need y'all to make some noise. All the way from Duval County, he is Star Florida tonight. Give it up for Cortez Blue! So if you want some, I said, where you came from. Look at all the women I've been cheated on before, nigga. They love that shit. Nigga, they singing that shit like day to day. Nigga, they slapping fives and everything, nigga. Y'all niggas don't even much know y'all girl done caught y'all cheating. She's sitting next to you, nigga. She done been all through your Facebook messages, nigga. Got me at a motherfucking church, nigga. I'm a whole deacon. This shit crazy, man. We're gonna have a good time at start, man. All the weed smokers make some noise. Oh, I was finna say, nigga, I know y'all ain't finna hide all the purple lips I seen when I walked in this bitch. Nigga, I had to quit smoking weed, nigga. I'm the person that smoke weed with people and I be fucking up the whole vibe. I'm smoking with my homeboy one day, I hit Jay. Hit that bitch again, and I passed it. And he passed it back. And the weed kicked in. I was like, why do they call them apartments? If they together. He was like, nigga, you gotta leave. I even do this shit when I'm in the home by myself. Nigga, I fuck around it. Smoke half a J and went and got some Mexican food. And I don't know what it is about Mexican food, but Mexican food go from mouth to ass. Like, it won't even touch the stomach. It go from mouth to ass. Man. I fucked around and got me some Mexican food. I'm eating that shit at the house. And that shit runs straight through me. And I go sit on the toilet. And I'm doodling. And I doodle some more. And the weed kicked in. I
I was like, I wonder how blind people know. I wonder how blind people know when to quit wiping. I got 20/20 vision and I still wipe my ass and I be like, ah, when the fuck I had corn, nigga. This shit is crazy, man. The world fucked up. But you know what's fucked up is the older I got, the more I realized that my family fucked up too. And you know who be the start of the fucked up in your family? Your motherfucking grandma. My grandma, she ain't shit. I'm glad she ain't here. She fucked around. She called me one day. She real superstitious. Like, she one of the people that believe if a black cat cross the road, when you got bad luck, you break the mirror. 7 years of bad luck. She called me one day. She was like, Ted, I had a dream about fish. Somebody pregnant. I hung the phone up. Like, what the fuck? I called her ass back the next day. I'm like, Granny, I had a dream about frying fish. I think somebody had an abortion. My family fucked up, man. My little cousin. That nigga gay. That nigga gay as gay can be. And he gonna try and introduce us to his gayness, what was it, Thanksgiving, they gonna try to come out the closet. Nigga, we been to use out the closet. And he gonna try to introduce us to his roommate. And this nigga got a roommate and his two men and they stay in a one-bedroom apartment. Like, nigga, we knew. Like, we been knew the nigga was gay because he was a gay baby. Like, the nigga was doing shit that baby. Matter of fact, I ain't even gonna say gay no more. Let's find another word. No, let's go well dressed. Let's go well dressed. That nigga said flamboyant. I like that. It's well go well. We been knew the nigga was well dressed because he was a well dressed baby. Like, sometimes he'll cry for his bottle and he'll get his bottle and he wouldn't even drink the milk. He just pour the milk on his chest and rub it in. Like, ah, that young nigga already know he wanted like that. I fucked around, I started babysitting, so I watched this nigga for a whole week. His mama came to me, she was like, can you do something to make him good at school? I was like, bet. I was like, if you be good at school all week, we're gonna go to Wendy's and get a frosty. Monday came, he was good. Tuesday came, he was good. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday came, he was good. Friday come, he was good. We go to Wendy's and we get us a frosty. Me being the man who I am, I got a spoon for my frosty. Him being who we thought he was, he got a straw for his frosty. Like, I see a lot of beautiful grown women in here tonight, and I don't know how strong, ma'am, I don't know how strong your jaws are. But for him to be 8 years old and suck a frosty through a straw. That nigga gotta be well dressed. All the women over 35, make some noise. I fuck with y'all. I do not fuck with these young bitches. These young bitches do not got they shit together. Fuck no. I do not fuck with no woman in her 20s. I don't. Because, like, you go to these young bitches' house and you see that they ain't got their shit together. Like, soon as you go to her house, you already know, like, yeah, I can't fuck with this bitch. As soon as you get to the door, that bitch in you must got no fucking floor mat. You're like, oh, this bitch whole front room dirty. I do not fuck with these young bitches. Then you get in the house and you start looking around and then you see that it ain't even much no curtains hanging up. This bitch got sheets hanging up. Like, bitch, that's why everybody here got a cold. I do not fuck with these young women, man. And I be seeing people talking about when you fuck with a woman for the first time, go check out the medicine cabinet. Man, fuck the medicine cabinet. That's not where it's at. That's not how you can learn the type of woman you got. Because you fuck around and look in the medicine cabinet, she got some shit that you can get a shot and get rid of in 2 weeks. You be like, oh, I'm back fucking with this bitch. Nah, fuck that. Go to the kitchen. The kitchen where it's at. That's where you see what type of woman you got. When you check out the kitchen. Because these young bitches' kitchen, it's so disturbing. It's so disturbing. And I'm going to give y'all a breakdown. I'm going to start from here, and I'm going to go here. I need y'all to follow me, all right? Y'all following me? Okay. We start down here with a pot set. These young bitches got these pots, and the motherfucking handles loose. You scared to fucking put this pot on this eye, because you might fucking run and drop that hot water on yourself. You like, bitch, you ain't got no screwdriver around this house? The man, this motherfucker. Then you go from here and you go to the next level. Then that's when you look at the silverware. You gotta check the silverware. Cause you don't know a bitch until you check the silverware. It be six people standing in this house. And she got three forks and two spoons. And a whole lot of butter knives. You like, bitch, all y'all can eat at the same time. Then you go to the top level. That's where the plates and the forks and the cups at. Oh, so fucking disgusting. These young bitches is just out of line with this shit. You start looking up there, you start seeing shit, these bowls and these plates and these cups, and none of them don't match. This bitch got country crock bowls and leftover Chinese bowls. Like, bitch, none of your shit don't match. You mean to tell me you ain't buy no set? Fuck around and you start looking at them bowls and you realize this bitch got these cheap ass bowls. You know them cheap bowls that you buy and it's like $3 for $1 and something? You know the plastic bowls I'm talking about? You know the fucking bowls that you can't eat spaghetti out of because they stain like a motherfucker? You're like, ah, this young bitch ain't got shit together. And no matter how many times you wash them bowls, it always look like you just ate spaghetti at the moment. And you can tell when a motherfucker had them bowls for a long time, can't you? Because it started getting that little white rash around. You're like, ah, bitch, I'm not about to eat out this bowl, but I'm going to have a sore throat I eat out this bowl, bitch. The motherfucking milk going to turn pink with this fucking... I love me a grown-ass woman. Y'all got y'all shit together. These young bitches, you call them in March and be like, hey, let's ride to Miami. You know what I'm saying? We're going to just have a little fun. She can be like, oh, I got to see if I got some PTO. Bitch, it's March. You done used all your time already. These grown women, shit. They got different shit. You get you a grown woman, about 40, 45. Nothing too old because my grandma's still alive. Get these grown women trying to take them out of town. They're gonna be like, come on. And I can get a little discount on the fucking hotel. You be like, oh, this grown woman got AARP. Like her. Fucking grown women different, man. These young bitches, you can just fuck these young bitches and go back home to your real family. These grown women, shit, it's different. I had to realize, I ain't even much know. I fucked around and got me a little grown-ass woman, put the dick on her, thought I did. Fucked around and fell asleep. I woke up, my clothes were folded on the edge of the bed. Like, man, this is different shit. Think I put my clothes on, trying to hurry up and leave. She was like, young man, come here. I was like, yes, ma'am. Because I still got respect. She was like, take that trash out and put it to the edge of the curb because my trash man come tomorrow. I was like, did this grown woman just make me do a chore for that pussy? Crazy, man. Shit, crazy. I had my first threesome last year, man. I had my first threesome. It was dope. It was interesting. It was wet. It was some new shit.
But it was different, like I said. It was me, her, and she was pregnant. I didn't know she was pregnant. I just thought the bitch had a little pudge on her. I've been on some pussy with a little pudge on top of it. I'm like, that's some new shit. Like, I'm used to fucking skinny bitches. So I seen a little pudge. I'm like, all right, shit. So I get her home to the crib, and then we go to fuck it. And I knew something was wrong, because every time I try and go deep, I feel something push me out. So I'm just like, I've been wanting this type of pussy. Shit just like, so I was like, all right, I'm gonna try my little favorite move. So I hit it with a 2 pumps and a swirl. Cause it's something about when you swirl that pussy, you can go deeper than you got. And it didn't work. And I was like, what's wrong? She was like, oh, I'm gonna let you know I'm pregnant. I was like, why the fuck you ain't tell me this from the beginning? I could have been him to this. Turn to the side. She turned to the side, got my dad, I went home to my real family. I seen her in Walmart earlier, well, not earlier this year, but like the summertime this year. And she was pushing a stroller. And I didn't realize that she was pushing the baby in the stroller. I'm just talking to her, and then I looked down, I'm like, oh shit, that could have been. So me being a comedian, I'm trying to make the baby laugh. So I'm like, ha, ha. The baby ain't laughing. I went to reach for the baby, and he jumped. I was like, oh shit, he remembered me. Start Florida, y'all good? Everybody who drank it, hold your drink up. Everybody who drank it, hold your drink up. I'm gonna go, everybody, if you drink it, if you got a bottle, hold your bottle up. Let me see it. I'm trying to see who ain't on antibiotics. Niggas like nigga shit. Nigga done start holding up cups of water. Nigga look. This shit is dope, man. I ain't never told jokes in the church. This is a church. Look at all these fucking steps. Ain't no regular building got this many steps in this motherfucking nigga. I'm about to have to repent like a bitch talking about fucking pregnant women and threesomes. This shit is gangster. Alright, baby. We having an amazing time for real. All the couples, make some noise. Okay, that's beautiful. Women in relationships, do us men a favor. Stop just giving hints. Stop giving a nigga a hint and getting mad because he don't pick up on your hint. Because men, we don't pick up hints. We don't. Like, you will fucking tell me you like this shirt while we in the mall. And you will get mad because I won't say buy that motherfucker. You'd be like, oh, this shirt go good with some shoes I got at the house. And bitch, I don't know. Shit, I'm just thinking you like this shirt. Because women don't pick up the hits themselves. Like, women don't pick up the hits, the main hit, from God above. God gave women a cycle from 3 to 7 days. That means the pussy closed down from 3 to 7 days. That means women should be sucking dick. Who the fuck talking like that back there? What y'all got going on? Why? Why you talking like that? You know it's a comedy show going on? Why you don't care? That's why you don't take niggas nowhere. You ain't used to coming out of the house.
I'm your motivated sister.
You who motivated sister? You don't motivate shit. This way. Do us a favor and shut up. Just one time, just shut up. Just, if you gotta talk, like, it's a whole ballroom back there. Shit, niggas drove all the way from Jacksonville and Tampa and Orlando. Let us get these jokes off. Talk to her later. You got her phone number. Who make who quit? Exactly. You see how she shut the fuck up? That's a man, nigga. I'm a grown ass man, nigga. You was not about to beat me in no talking match. I don't give a fuck. Shut up. You don't tell these jokes. Sit down and enjoy the show because there's some funny niggas up here. You talking and you missing these jokes. And you put that red dress, you put that red onesies on. And guess what? You thought she was fine. You built like a fucking sack of laundry, bitch. You gotta sit your dirty laundry built ass down, nigga. I don't give a fuck. You don't respect this microphone. You is. I'ma win. Because I'm a professional and this is what I do. And I know I'm the star of Florida. And when I go outside, I might have to get to fighting, but guess what? I had already knew I might be in the country, so I put my gun in the front seat, and I didn't even put the motherfucking belt on seatbelt on that motherfucker. So if we gonna get to brawling, this is what we gonna do. We gonna have fun, but we gonna tell these jokes, and we gonna enjoy this show. But with everything I just said, I was just playing, so y'all please don't fuck with me, because I just started my job, so my insurance ain't kicked in. Fuck that. Hey, man. My new country niggas, y'all know how to fight. Nigga, y'all don't do shit to play football and fight. Fuck that. One of y'all niggas beat me, I'm gonna be mad as a motherfucker. I can't go home and tell my girlfriend I got in a car accident. Fuck y'all, nigga. Shit. I got a bullshit job, too. You ever get a new job and you get your first paycheck and you look at that bitch like it's a bad head or spade? I'm like, yeah, go throw that bitch back in, man. I don't know who the fuck check that is, man. It's not mine, man. Shit, crazy. How long I been up here? I been up here long enough. I need to get off this bitch. Was that funny? Was y'all fucking me again if I come back? I got a couple claps, so shit, I mean, I ain't gotta go back to Jacksonville right now, so I mean I can get me some little start pussy. So. I don't get my ass off the stage, man. Hey, I appreciate y'all. Hey, if y'all got Instagram, y'all make sure y'all fuck with me. My name is Tez, Tez_Brooks. Follow me. I want you to follow me because the light-skinned girl right here. You've been scamming me the whole show, and I've been trying to look at you. You look like you got some badass kids. You probably got two of them. And you ain't laugh yet. Oh, you finally laugh. Okay, cool.